kicked off in Germany. Over the weekend, there'll be events across the country, but the main focus will be on Berlin, which became the capital after the momentous fall of the wall back in 1989. Claire Williams has the story for us.
Fertig. Los!
Tracing the wall's route through Berlin, 8,000 balloons were lit up as night fell on the German capital. Germany was divided during the Cold War by a 155-kilometre system of barriers. The wall in Berlin went up in 1969 to prevent East Germans trying to escape to the West. Former Soviet President Mikhail Gorbachev is a key figure in the commemorations. On Friday evening, he visited the landmark Cold War crossing, Checkpoint Charlie, and left an imprint of his hand in cement.
Experience is proof. When Russia and Germany are friendly to each other, Europe is peaceful, and they're good, and the world is better. Let's not forget about that.
Earlier in the day, German MPs listened to Wolf Biermann perform in the Bundestag.
The fall of the wall was the flashpoint of 1989, a decisive year. But it was not a miracle. It was the result of a peaceful revolution unprecedented in German history.
Biermann was stripped of his East German citizenship in 1976. During his performance, he had a brief but heated exchange with members of the far-left Die Linke, successor to the party that once ruled East Germany. The commemorations culminate on Sunday evening, 25 years to the day after the wall came down. To the sounds of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, the anthem of Europe, the balloons will be set loose into the sky.
Right, you're up to date. More news in 15 minutes' time. Join us then.
In Ligue 1 on Friday, an 89th minute strike from Pedro Henrique saw Rennes pass Lorient in the Brittany derby. Later today, Lens hosts third place Bordeaux, while Nantes will look to extend their 7-game unbeaten run in Caen. Guingamp, Lille and Saint-Étienne, who played in the Europa League on Thursday, were all in action on Sunday. Zlatan Ibrahimovic was back at training for Paris Saint-Germain on Friday as the French champions prepare to host rivals Marseille in Le Classique on Sunday. Marseille currently top the table by 4 points, but they haven't beaten the capital club in nearly 3 years. Defender Nicolas Nkoulou says that Paris, who sealed their place in the Champions League knockout stages in midweek, will be favourites at the Parc des Princes.
They'll
be playing at home. At the end of the day, Paris are Paris. I think they are favourites to win the league. But we'll be hoping for a good result at the Parc des Princes. It's true that PSG have had a few problems at the start of this campaign, but I get the feeling that they're improving, and we'll have to be very focused for the game if we want to get anything out of it. Marseille have the chance to open up a 7-point gap at the top. Ibrahimovic is expected to start on the bench for PSG after 7 weeks out with a heel injury. English Premier League high flyer Southampton officially opened their new state-of-the-art training complex, the Marcus Liebherr Pavilion, on Wednesday. The facility will help the Saints build on their good start to the season, but Southampton boss Ronald Koeman insists that maintaining that impressive start with a home win over Leicester later today does not change the fact it is still a two-horse title race.
I think it's a two-teams race, because still I believe that that City and Chelsea are more stronger over the whole season, not in one game, because I think we can beat them. But on the whole season, normally they are more stronger than we. But okay, we know our situation, we know our ambition, but we live game by game, and it's not important and not necessary to look more forward, because in my opinion, that's not the best way to be successful.
A Southampton win against Leicester could see them move to within a point of leaders Chelsea, depending on their results against Liverpool.
After back-to-back defeats in La Liga, Barcelona are looking to get back to winning ways later today. After losing out to arch-rivals Real Madrid, Barca then surprisingly slipped up at home to Celta Vigo, with the results dropping them from first to fourth in the table. But boosted by a midweek Champions League win over Ajax, Luis Enrique now wants a Liga win against Almeria. This is a team that still has not won a home match this season. However, they are playing better than they did last campaign. They reinforced well, buying good players. Obviously, they still have a very good coach from last term as well. They will try to make things difficult for us, as all teams do when we come to play them. They will try to make it difficult for us to score. 2003 was the last time Barca lost three games in a row, but the Catalans have a strong record against Almeria, who are only a point above the relegation zone. Córdoba and Deportivo La Coruña played out a goalless draw in La Liga on Friday evening. Leaders Real Madrid host Rayo Vallecano later today before defending champions Atletico Madrid travel to Real Sociedad on Sunday. Elsewhere, second place Valencia host Athletic Bilbao, while Sevilla face Levante. With less than a year to go before the Rugby World Cup, France are among the Northern Hemisphere countries looking to shine against southern rivals in the November friendlies. Due to injuries and bad results, France coach Philippe Saint-André has brought in some fresh faces for the three-game series that starts later today against Fiji in Marseille. It means first call-ups for Bayern fullback Scott Spedding, plus Racing pair Alexandre Dumoulin and winger Teddy Thomas. It is a strange feeling for me. My relatives are satisfied, as are my family. I am also happy to get the chance to wear this blue shirt. I don't think it has sunk in yet. I'm not worrying about it too much. I will not forget what I have to do, what I need to accomplish on the pitch. For a winger like me, I am expected to finish my teammates' good moves and not to give the Fijian players too much space defensively. In the 25-man French squad, there will be four players born outside of France. Bernard Leroux has already played in the French jersey, but for Scott Spedding, Rory Cocotte and Winnie Antonio, it will be the first time, a source of pride for Bayern fullback Spedding. Honestly, it has been heartwarming. I have received so many messages from people at all the clubs in France, not only Bayonne. I feel that the whole country is behind me, and I will give everything in order to do the shirt justice. After Fiji, France will go on to face Australia and Argentina in consecutive weeks, while the Fijians next play Wales before meeting the USA before the end of the month.
Bhopal Revisited.
In December 1984, an explosion at a chemical plant in northern India released a toxic cloud into the atmosphere.